Hello friends, welcome you all again. Today we have a case study of Rohtang Tunnel, and this Rohtang Tunnel is very famous for the Indian prospect. So basically we will discuss about the geological condition those were occurred during the construction of this Rohtang Tunnel in high altitude region. So there were so many challenges from the climate, from the geological aspects also. So we will discuss one by one, and this comes under the case study of the Rohtang Tunnel. So we will discuss about the geological aspect, and this tunnel is right now known as the Atal Tunnel also. So let's start with this tunnel. So first of all, location. So basically this Rohtang Tunnel connect the Manali in the south and Keelong in the north in the Pir Panjal range. So this Pir Panjal range is very famous. So the total length of the Rohtang Tunnel is 8.802 kilometer, and the major rock type, so basically there are alternate bands of the uniformly dipping of phyllite, schist, gneiss, and some migmatites also. So migmatite also. So due to this complex geology in the regions, there were so many geological surprises during the construction, and due to these geological surprises, there was delay for the commission of this tunnel. So the condition of the overburden, so the minimum overburden was there 600 meter and the maximum 1900 meter. So this 1900 meter is very high overburden cover. So due to this high cover, there were some problems due to de-stressing of the rock. So there was de-stressing conditions also there due to this high overburden. The shape of the tunnel is horseshoe shape, and the finish width is the 10 meter. Okay, at the road level. So the construction technique that was used during the construction is New Australian Tunneling Method, that is also known as the NATM. So this data is basically taken from the Singh et al. 2019. This is a research paper published by Singh et al. 2019. So we have a location of the Rohtang Tunnel. We can see on the Google map here. This is the southern end and this is the northern end. So this is northern end, and it's connect the Leh Highway here, and this is the southern end towards the Manali region. So in this tunnel is passes through the high mountainous region that is also known as the Pir Panjal range. Now what is the significance of this tunnel? Okay, so basically this tunnel is reduced the distance between Leh and Manali approximately 46 kilometer, and the other significance or aspect is this tunnel provide the access to the Leh throughout the year, because this is high, and this tunnel is situated at high elevation. So during the winter season, this road was blocked due to the snowfall. So this is the main advantage, means Indian prospect view. If we talk about the from the Indian prospect view, so this tunnel provide the access to the Leh Ladakh by road through this region throughout the year. Okay, then this is the, we can say this is the highest road tunnel at 3000 meter elevation. So this is the highest, not the longest. This thing keep remember. So now let's discuss the geology of the area. So as I have already told you, the geology of the area is very complex, and there are so many formation, that is Tandi formation, then Betal formation, Salkala formation, Salkala group, and the Rohtang Gneissing complex is also existing here. So the geology is very complex in this region. We can say Salkala group is the Precambrian rock. Okay, and the main rock type along is phyllite, quartzite, mica schist, and migmatite, and the gneisses. Those are alternatively occurred during the construction of the this Atal Tunnel. So major geological structures, as we can see, Siri Nala. Siri Nala is very famous, and due to this Siri Nala fault, this tunnel means face so many problems during construction, because due to this Siri Nala, lots of debris flow throughout the tunnel. So basically in DPR stage, this Siri Nala fault was identified, but during construction, due to this fault, construction worker faced so many problems. then Chandrakoti structure, Rohtang ridge structure, then Dhundi structure, Palchan structure, and Panchal faults also occurred in this region, then Sundarnagar fault, and the main is main central thrust. Such type of structure means exist at the site, and due to these structural features, the construction work hampered. So the structural geology is very, very important during the investigation of the tunnel as well as the construction of the tunnel also. So let's see the symmetric cross section here. So we have symmetric cross section. This is not in scale. So this cross section is basically taken from the KK Sharma research paper that was published in 2016. So you can see this red line is the tunnel alignment, and you can see different types of the rock. Mica schist, migmatites, then phyllite, we have phyllite, then Sirinala fault is basically exist in this region. So due to this Sirinala, what happened when the construction was going on, lots of debris comes out through the tunnels along with the water. So due to this region, what happened, this excavation work was hampered. What was the treatment? So the treatment is basically engineers take the dressing technology here and they increase the length of the rock bolt. Okay, then they provide the ribs also. Then after then they provide the shotcreting. Okay, so this was the treatment there. So basically the main treatment was the dressing technology. So they provide the dressing technology for the Sirinala fault during the construction of this tunnel. So you can see the different structure. This is the Chandrakoti structures. This is the northern portal. Then we have Rohtang ridge structure here that is exist here. And you can see this is the high rock cover region here. So due to this high rock cover regions, there was lots of problem for the de-stressing condition. As you can see here, we have marked the hatching here and hatching here also. So due to this de-stressing condition, this construction of the tunnel was affected. So what was the geological problems? So geological problems are, first of all, roof collapse. So as you can see, as we have discussed before, loose rock falls exist and squeezing condition, high deformation of the roof occurred at the Sirinala, and Sirinala flooded the tunnel with rock debris. Okay, then geological surprise in the form of glacial fret, Sirinala, that was the biggest problem during the construction in 2012. Okay, then one more thing, the highly fragile strata in the form of the schist. In the form of schist, highly fragile strata was existed there due to this alternate band of the schist with quartz band. What happened, there was lots of problem of the overbreaking. Okay, then one more problem was there, that is climatic condition. Due to the snowfall, the work was hampered and work was stopped every year for the 4 months. So due to this climatic condition, there was a problem. Okay, then roof collapse in the Rohtang tunnel, we will discuss this one in the detail. As you can see in the photographs, this is the de-stressing condition in the roof collapsing site at the northern portal of the tunnel. So here what happened, the overburden thickness was up to 1.9 kilometer, or we can say 1900 meter. So due to these stressing condition, what happened, rocks are collapsing downward side and it's covered approximately 50 meter in the length. So the rock, the major rock type here is the schist with alternate bands of the quartz. So what is the tendency of the schist? Basically schist is composed by the mica minerals. So mica tendency is the flaky in nature. So due to that flaky in nature, they means ride to each others, and due to riding of the minerals, what happened, the de-stressing means applied vertically and collapse the and make the cavity at the caverns approximately up to 50 meter in the length. So this was occurred in 2013. Then you can see, if you want to read the support measurement during the Rohtang tunnel, so you can read this paper. This is LM Singh et al. 2019. You can see 2019, they published this article based on the support system of the Rohtang tunnel. So I hope this lecture will help you to create the case study of the Rohtang tunnel and the geology of the Rohtang tunnel. So this is the end of the video. Thank you very much.